Good day, folks. Today, it's me, myself, Sadr Rahman here. And as you might have seen me in a couple of the other interviews in which I would reach out to people who have been, who have had their success stories to tell and their little Canadian journeys. So I thought, and a couple of folks who asked me that, okay, what is your journey? So I thought, okay, let me take this opportunity to talk a little bit about myself. I came in here in 2009, a short story, started working as a survival job for about 7-8 months alongside I was doing a BA business analysis course at the University of Toronto and then I took a couple of other courses with organizations where they will normally place you. Anyway, after that I landed in an organization as a professional job in the managed services capacity, and then from there within 6 months I started reporting into my boss. His name was Mark Hayward, a great mentor who has helped me a lot. And at this point, I want to emphasize the fact that mentors play a very big role in how you charter your journey in Canada. For me, Mark played a critical role, not just guiding me in that particular role, but he has been guiding me in the same way for the last 10 years now. So we're still very good friends. Wanted to emphasize the importance of mentors. Beyond that, so after completing my stint at Flexity Solutions, I went on to work for the City of Edmonton as a contractor. I worked there, then went on to work with Enbridge Pipelines, I came back to Toronto, started working for Ontario Public Service, completed that, went on to to work with CIBC. And then afterwards, while I was at CIBC, I applied for an MBA at Ryerson, got admitted there. Started doing my MBA, and so I left the CIBC when I moved into the full-time program. While I was at in the first third month of my MBA, I got a position, a full-time position that was offered to me at Deloitte for a senior consultant. So then I completed my MBA, very interesting journey at Ryerson. I think that experience has been a very tremendous experience in itself. Went on to win the Economist case competition with my team, with Kristen and Jesse. And then we took part in the MBA games. Very interesting experience. For all those folks who are coming out and want to understand the, want to really get integrated pretty quickly, I would recommend them to take some kind of education from here in Canada. Anyway, after completing the MBA from Ryerson, then I joined Deloitte, worked for Deloitte for about 1.5 years. I completed that stint, went on to work for PwC, worked there for a little while on a contract, and then I started doing my own stint under Changing Skies, my company. We did a couple of contracts, started working on new ideas, and we formed a company, Excel Alliance, and then we worked on that with a couple of other partners, 7-8 partners with me. It was mostly a training institute. Then we packed up that business, and then I started working for CIBC once again. And after completing with CIBC, I went on to work with again with PwC, and that was my last contract. So this was, in a nutshell, my journey up till now. As you can see, I moved from one role to another. Approximately like in the last 9 to 10 years, I worked in approximately 9 to 11 organizations, seen a lot of sectors. So, and that's my advice. One advice that I would like to give folks is the fact that when you are doing something, do it to the fullest. I mean, like, even if you get paid for 8 hours, you should kind of put in some extra hours, like 10 hours, if you really want to keep moving forward, and continue to invest in your education, training, meeting new people, regardless of if you are in a job or out of a job. Don't start networking when you are out of a job, because that's when it'll come across pretty strangely when you go out into the market and asking and contacting people, because then they know that you're looking for a job. You should have contacts regardless, and you should be in touch with people, try to help as many people out as you can. And along the way, you will see that in different ways. Like for me, I've seen that opportunities just come out of the blue, which I would never have even thought about. So those are some interesting aspects to think about. And so I talked about volunteering. Volunteering is also one of those aspects where we get involved in the community. Try to give back whatever you know there. And there's definitely something that people say, okay, I don't have any skill, what should I give back on? There's always something to give back. There's your time. It's not always about money. It's always not about, you can actually just help and guide people. Then probably that could also be a really good help at any point in time for anybody. Anyway, that's about it. It's not much of a success story, I would say, but it's a little bit of a Canadian journey. People wanted to know about it, so I thought of, I'll share it. One thing that I would like to say here is that, and we really need to realize this fact that everybody has their own journey in Canada. Do not try to compare yourself with anybody. You are led by your circumstances. So you have to make the best decision for what works in your situation. Just remember that, and hopefully don't get disappointed if there is challenges. They are there to make you even stronger. So best of luck. Thank you so much.